Yes, students, assalamu alaikum. I wish Eid greetings to all of you, and my sympathy is to those who are in different quarantine centers and even celebrated their Eid there. The world is going with a tough time, that's COVID-19. It's putting huge amount of pressure on the globe. More than 350,000 people died worldwide because of this deadly virus. It is better for you to remain inside your homes so that this infection may not reach to you. It is class 11th, subject political science, topic right to constitutional remedies. Yesterday I received a phone call from a student where he demanded that the right to constitutional remedies is a very important right and you need to throw light on the same right. Dear students, as we are enjoying six fundamental rights in the Indian Constitution, which are given in the part 3rd of the Indian Constitution from Article 14 to 35. And before me, these fundamental rights are meaningless and null and void until right to constitutional remedies is there. Remedies simply means therapy, control, or treatment. Right to constitutional remedies safeguards your rest of the rights. Father of Indian Constitution, Bhimrao Ambedkar, said that this right, right to constitutional remedies, is the soul and heart of the Indian Constitution. And this right is mentioned in the Article 32 of the Indian Constitution. If your fundamental rights are violated, for example, your right to freedom is violated, you can move to the court, directly to the Supreme Court or High Court, for enforcement of these rights because of this right to constitutional remedies. So summarizing the fact, right to constitutional remedies is that right in which if person's fundamental rights are violated, he can move to the court, even apex court of the country, that is Supreme Court of the country, for enforcement of these rights, and also the High Court of the state for enforcement, for the protection of these rights. And High Court or Supreme Court can issue some writs, which you know that are writs of habeas corpus, writs of habeas corpus, mandamus, certiorari, and quo warranto. And one's fundamental rights by issuing these writs are protected. So briefly, right to constitutional remedies is well mentioned in Article 32 of the Indian Constitution. It safeguards the rest of the rights that we enjoy under our Constitution from Article 14 to 35. So it's very important right in our Constitution. Briefly, we can say right to constitutional remedies is that right in which a person can move to the High Court or Supreme Court of India for enforcement of these rights if your fundamental rights are violated. For example, right to freedom we are enjoying from Article 19 to 22. If these rights are violated by any agency, whether it is a government agency or a person, you can move to the court, move to the apex court using Article 32 of the Indian Constitution, and also can move to the High Court using 226 Article of the Indian Constitution. Dear students, space of the network here in J&K is very low, and we always find it difficult to upload video of 100 MB on social media sites. You are preparing video at 9 a.m. in the morning and it gets uploaded at 5 p.m. in the evening. So it's tough time, but something is better than nothing. We have been asked to deliver online and offline so the students get benefited a little bit. Books are available with you. Go on reading books and you will get the concept clear. Today it's enough for you, and tomorrow or day after tomorrow I shall be live again for next class. I will throw a detailed light on the right to constitutional remedies so that you will grasp the concept well. Thanks.